Adverbial clauses, and this is part three, and here we look at reason clauses. The most common of these, or the most common subordinating conjunction that we would use, is because, and most people are familiar with this word. And an example, Laura studied English because she saw the opportunities that would create or that would be created. Your main clause, Laura studied English, and then the reason why, because she saw the opportunities it would create. So she did this because of all of that. That is the reason. If we look at another example, here we put the subordinating conjunction first, therefore the subordinate clause first. That's why we have a comma here, followed by the main clause. Because surfing was popular in his town, Roger bought a surfboard. Why did he buy the surfboard? Because surfing was popular in his town. That's the reason why. Let's look at a slightly different structure. Now, this is not a reason clause, so I'll just make a note of that. It's not a reason clause. This actually requires a noun structure, as we're about to see. Because of the popularity of surfing in his town, comma, Roger bought a surfboard. So this is the subordinate part, and this is the main part again. But here you see, when we put the of, because of, we end up with a noun, the popularity. Now this is a noun phrase, the popularity of surfing, and this is just a little prepositional phrase. So this doesn't have the subject or the verb, so it's clearly not a clause, but I thought it's worth grouping it in here. Let's look at the next one. As, since, and for, these serve the same function as because, but they're just a little bit more formal. So I might make a note, and we'll say that they're more formal. And here are some examples. So a very formal sounding example. The company has decided to reduce its exposure to risk because the market is unusually volatile. Volatile means going up and down. Prices are going up and down in the market. So here again, we're just showing why they reduced their exposure to risk. And you could have just as easily put as or since in this position. You wouldn't need to change anything else. They have the same function. They simply are a little bit more formal. But just be a little bit careful here. I'll give you a warning. This is also used with time. So just be careful there's not some confusion created because of this time function that this one will have, this subordinating conjunction. There's one other way to do it, as we see here, if you've got for. But for is a little bit outdated, so I'll make a note of that as well. It's outdated, which means it's a bit old-fashioned now and it's not used very much. Okay, let's continue. We have seeing that or seeing as. Now, these are used mostly in a sort of an informal. Actually, we don't need red. There's no error there. So let's use green. So they're normally used in an informal context or for informal uses. And we'll look at a couple of examples. Because the weather is fine, we should have a barbecue. So subordinate clause here and main clause there. Now, having barbecues and deciding whether to have a barbecue, that's a fairly informal context, unlike the one above, where we're talking about our company and the outlook for the company, which is a fairly formal context. So we use these formal coordinating conjunctions. Here, being relatively informal in context, we can use seeing that or seeing as. And so you would just simply swap them in. So seeing that or seeing as, either one. Seeing that the weather is fine, we should have a barbecue. Let's move to the next one. So this is fairly formal and a little tricky to use, but let's have a look at an example. And I'll just show you that you can put all of this together. So in as much as separate, or all separate words, in as much as. Another one that has the same function is in that, which is a different structure. So we can probably conclude that deserts are too hot and dry for penguins, in as much as none can be found there. And by none, we mean no penguins. So what we're actually doing here is giving more detail and expressing our idea with more clarity. So why can we conclude that deserts are too hot and dry for penguins? Because none are found there. So if you want to just give more detail to a point that you've already made, you can, in a formal context, you can use in as much as. In the same way, you can use in that. And let's look at, I'll just maybe note that. So this could have been in that with no other changes to the sentence. And a final example here is madness alone is truly terrifying, inasmuch as you cannot placate it either by threats, persuasion, or bribes. And to placate it means to pacify it or make it peaceful. And a bribe is obviously when you give money sort of in a immoral context. So there you go. That they're saying it's truly terrifying, madness. And why? Because you can't make it peaceful by these means. Now, we're going to look at so here. So can function a little bit like because, but I think what you'll find is it complicates things. If we use because, we have this sentence. Because surfing was popular in his town, Roger bought a surfboard. Now, if we tried to use so, it would get quite confusing in that we would have to reverse the importance of the clauses. So surfing was popular in his town, so Roger bought a surfboard. Here, surfing was popular in his town was subordinate, and Roger bought a surfboard was the main clause. Here, we actually have to swap this to the main clause, and this is subordinate. The reason that this happens is because here we have a, what do we have? We have reason clause. But here we actually have result. The function is result. So if I had tried to put so here, we'd end up with so surfing was popular in his town, Roger bought a surfboard. So it makes no sense at all. So that would actually be an error in that position. So is not quite a reason conjunction. So it's something to be aware of. And so that ends part 3 of adverbial clauses. And you may now want to watch part 4.